Hello, and welcome to the Numbers of Thoth. If you're fascinated by the mysteries of ancient Egypt, you're in the right place. In today's video, we'll uncover the incredible story of one of the British Museum's most famous mummies, Ginger, the Gebelein Man. Before we dive in, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and turn on the notification bell so you never miss an update about the wonders of ancient Egypt. And if you're craving even more exclusive content and in-depth articles, check out my Substack using the link below. Now, let's embark on this journey into pre-dynastic Egypt. The Gebelein Man, affectionately nicknamed Ginger or Ginge due to his striking red hair, is one of the best-preserved mummies ever discovered. He was found in Gebelein, or modern-day Naga el-Gherira, just 25 miles south of Thebes. Unlike the carefully prepared mummies of later periods, Ginger's preservation was entirely natural. His shallow grave was filled with hot desert sand, which dried out and protected his body for over 5,000 years. Dating back to the late pre-dynastic period, around 3400 BC, Ginger is one of the oldest known examples of mummification. At that time, Egyptians were buried in oval pit graves, often placed in a fetal position as though they were sleeping. But Ginger's story is far from peaceful. Recent research has revealed that his death was anything but natural. To uncover the truth, experts from the British Museum took Ginger to the Bupa Cromwell Hospital in London for a CT scan. What they found was extraordinary and tragic. The scans revealed that Ginger was between 18 and 21 years old at the time of his death, and that he was murdered. He was stabbed in the back, just above his left shoulder. The force of the blow shattered his shoulder blade and broke two of his ribs, injuries so severe that he would have died almost instantly. But this wasn't the only fascinating discovery. Using infrared technology, scientists identified tattoos on Ginger's body, making him one of the earliest known humans with distinguishable tattooed images, alongside Ötzi the Iceman. Ginger's tattoos, invisible to the naked eye, became clear under modern imaging. Two horned animals appeared on his right arm, believed to represent either a bull or a Barbary sheep. These symbols likely held deep meaning, with the bull signifying male virility and status, and the Barbary sheep symbolizing hunting prowess and strength. Ginger offers us a hauntingly personal glimpse into life and death during a pivotal era of Egypt's history. But his tragic fate was not unique. The pre-dynastic period was a time of significant conflict and violence. Archaeological evidence from sites like Wadi Qubniyya and Gebel Sahaba reveals that intergroup violence and warfare were likely common. At Gebel Sahaba, located just across the modern border in northern Sudan, archaeologists uncovered a late Paleolithic cemetery dating back to around 12,000 BC. Shockingly, nearly half of the individuals buried there showed signs of violent deaths, with flint arrow and spear fragments embedded in their skeletons. Some suffered gruesome injuries, like a young woman struck by as many as 21 projectiles. Another shocking example of human barbarity comes from the grave of two children. Buried together, both children have flint fragments lodged in their necks indicating they were possibly executed side by side. These findings reveal a harsh and dangerous world, where survival often came at a great cost. Ginger's story, though tragic, is a window into this turbulent time, connecting us to the humanity and struggles of our ancient ancestors. Remarkably, Ginger wasn't alone. Buried alongside him was the body of a woman who also bore tattoos. Research suggests the tattooing process in ancient Egypt was surprisingly similar to today's methods. A needle was likely used to insert a carbon-based substance, probably soot, under the skin. Experts believe that, given the Egyptians' reputation for fine craftsmanship, they would have been exceptionally skilled at tattooing as well. For a long time, archaeologists assumed tattooing was reserved for women, often linked to fertility or erotic symbolism. However, the discovery of tattoos on both Ginger and the woman buried near him proves that tattooing was practiced on both sexes. Preserved for over 5,000 years, Ginger's remains provide a chilling yet awe-inspiring glimpse into humanity's journey toward civilization. His tattoos, his violent death, and his remarkable preservation make him a fascinating figure in the history of ancient Egypt. Thank you for joining me on this journey into the mysteries of pre-dynastic Egypt. If you found this story as captivating as I did, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to check out my Substack for more exclusive content exploring the hidden stories of ancient Egypt. Let's keep uncovering the incredible legacy of Egypt together.